Well, Greece first kind of crossed my path. I first became aware of Greece pretty much last fall, and it actually was a bit of an outcrop for my last piece for The Prospect, which was about a group of former homeschooled young adults who are now kind of speaking out about their experiences growing up and arguing for reform. And so, in some of these different communities of ex-homeschoolers, as well as former fundamentalists or ex-fundamentalists or ex-queerful girls, people were starting to talk about this new organization, GRACE, run by Billy Graham's grandson, which was going and doing investigations into abuses in some of the institutions that they were very familiar with. Well, yeah, GRACE is really uniquely positioned for this task to go in and do investigations into sexual abuse at schools like Bob Jones or missionary groups like New Tribes or ABWE because they have impeccable evangelical credentials. You almost couldn't come from a more kind of storied line of evangelicals than to be Billy Graham's grandson and to be working at Liberty University, Jerry Falwell's legacy school. So when Grace is called to go into some of these schools or these institutions, they are coming from the same perspective, or generally a much closer perspective to a school like Bob Jones than, say, an outside secular legal firm or set of investigators. Bob Jones hired Grace at the very end of 2012, and I think that all became pretty public in the first months of 2013, when Grace started to do a lot of their interviews and request a lot of documentation. And this process went on for about a year. And then this past January, January 2014, Grace announced that they were almost complete with their investigation of Bob Jones University and its response to sexual assault claims. And just a few weeks later, Bob Jones kind of stunned Grace and stunned all of the survivors who had interviewed with them by announcing that they were terminating them. Their termination letter really honestly gave no reason why. There was just kind of some mention that Bob Jones was undergoing some very significant transformations, that their longtime president was resigning and that they were going to be facing search for a new executive. But really, beyond that, there was no indication of why they were firing Grace, of what complaints they might have with Grace. And this became part of the big blow-up that followed that, as not just people at Bob Jones, but people all across the country and in national media began to really kind of come down on Bob Jones and say, why did you let these people go? And what was your rationale for that? And there really wasn't one that was made public. Bob Jones says that they brought Grace in the first place because they were acting proactively. This was just following the terrible sex abuse scandal at Penn State University. We have seen, even just in the past month, we've seen a tremendous number of colleges and schools that are being investigated for Title IX violations by the US government. So this is really a widespread issue of how colleges are dealing with campus rape and campus sexual assault. So Bob Jones said it was being proactive and taking a step to address students who they may have, quote, underserved in the past. People more familiar with the school and people who are critics of the school say instead that Bob Jones was responding to a very specific incident that actually didn't take place at the school. That was the story of Tina Anderson, who 14 years ago was raped by a deacon in her church in New Hampshire. And how that has anything to do with Bob Jones is that the pastor of the church was himself a Bob Jones graduate, a Bob Jones board member, a member of several additional Bob Jones boards that dealt with children and missionary work. So this was a man who was very much kind of in the broader Bob Jones community. But he had been found and kind of exposed on national TV having responded to this young woman's rape, not by comforting her, not by taking her to the police to report the crime, but by making her stand before the congregation while he read a confession of her pregnancy just before she was sent away out of state for the duration of her pregnancy until she gave birth to the child. Bob Jones University isn't just like any other Christian school. For a long time, Bob Jones was kind of the premier destination choice for very fundamentalist Christian students. This was the college you would go to if you were from that community. But it wasn't just the school. It was also a set of affiliated feeder schools. So they have their own Bob Jones Academy there in Greenville, South Carolina, but that there are also schools across the country that tend to send their students to Bob Jones. There is also a huge network of Bob Jones affiliated churches. And in some ways, the affiliation is so strong that it almost functions as a de facto denomination. People from these churches will either send money back to Bob Jones University, or they will send their congregants' children to Bob Jones University. And actually, when Bob Jones University students graduate, they are sent, they're sent to an office on campus to look at a list of approved churches across the country. So if you are moving, say, to Columbus, Ohio, you go and you look at the list of, the several Bob Jones approved churches for Columbus, Ohio. And in that way, it's not just Bob Jones sending its students out into the world, but it's sending them very much to a specific world, and they stay very much within the fold, even after graduation. Mm-hmm.